This is dedicated to everybody that was down from day one. Welcome to Death Row. Switch.
It was like this, you know, for its beginning, it was just an idea, a vision I had, Dre had. We basically knew what, you know, what we was gonna do, like on different shit. We had a concept for us, before we started the label, I mean, Dre was on Ruthless. He wasn't happy. I mean, you got one of the best producers, or the best producers in the business, who not getting the credibility and the publicity that he deserved, and probably the money part. So we just, you know, he got at me and said, well, look, why don't you manage me, help me with my shit, get my shit right. So I did that. And I was like, well, fuck it. I knew that him and Easy was starting the record label together. When shit hit, Jerry came in, moved Dre out the way, and him and Easy became more partners.
My boy.
Hey, what's up, Daddy? How you doing?
All right.
Hey, what is that? A new thing you got there.
All right. How you doing?
Oh, man, I'm chilling. How you doing?
Doing fine.
Yeah, it's good.
You know, the problem with this business, people just don't trust each other. I'm glad you and I trust each other. You trust me, don't you?
Yeah, boss.
Oh, no. I work for you. I work for Sleazy E. I wouldn't have it any other way. We're going to make lots of money.
That's good.
All right, so now that the contracts are signed,
mm-hmm.
It's time for you to go find me some rappers.
Okay.
You ready to get rich?
Ready.
You ready to make money?
I'm ready.
You ready to buy a house?
I'm ready.
A car?
Yes.
You go find the talent.
Yes.
You trust me.
Gotcha.
All right, go, boy.
I'm out.
Go, boy.
Gotcha.
So I'm like, fuck all that going back, tripping like, you know, you did this, I did this. Unless, you know, we can't go back and change the past, but we can deal with the present. So I was like, we could start the label. He was with it, I was with it. So that's when we started Death Row.
Yeah. Hell yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Mr. Buster, where you at? Can't scrap a lick, so I know you got your gap. Just stay on hard from ganking your raw dogs. The hood you threw up with, homies you grew up with, don't even respect your ass. So now it's time for the doctor to check your ass, fool. Used to be my homie, used to be my ace. Now I wanna slap the taste out your mouth. Make it bow down to the road. Ganking me, now I'm ganking you, little hoe. Oh, don't think I forgot, let you slide. Let me ride, just another homicide. Yeah, it's me, so I'ma talk on. Stomping on the easiest streets that you can walk on. So strap on your Compton hat, your lopes, and watch your back, cause you might get smoked low. And pass the buzz, and stay low key, big chick, cause you lost all your homies' love. Now call it what you want to. You trip with me, now it's a must that I trip with you.
Wow, 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 yippee-yo, yippee-yay, doggy dogs definitely in the house. Bow, wow, wow, yippee-yo, yippee-yay, Death Row's definitely in the house. Bow, wow, wow, yippee-yo, yippee-yay, the sounds of a dog brings me to another day. Play with my bone, would you, Timmy? It seems like you're good for making jokes about your Jimmy. Well, here's a Jimmy joke about your mama that you might not like. I heard she was a Frisco dyke, but on the wrist deals, I'm talking about you and me, toe-to-toe. M-U-T, your bark was loud, but your bite wasn't vicious. And them rhymes you were kicking were quite bootylicious. You get what doggy dog, oh, is he crazy? With your mama and your daddy hollering, baby. So what that let you know? That if you step to Drake, fool, you step in a Death Row. And I ain't even swagging them things. I'm hollering 187 with my gat in your mouth, fool.
Yeah, Long Beach and Compton together on this track. And just when you thought we were slipping, boo yeah, right back at you.
At the time, we didn't have no deal. We had artists, we were signing artists left and right. You know, for us, the ones we have now, the ones we started with. And you know, we was paying them, we paid for everything out of our pocket. Put all the ends up. We made the, we made the Chronic and shit. After making the Chronic, I'm about to fuck you up, man. That light fucking me up. We made the Chronic. We was like, fuck it. Let's go in and make the record. I throw out some chips, make it happen. Instead of like going to a major record label or a distributor saying, we got an idea and a concept to put out the Chronic, which is Dr. Dre's solo album, featuring these new artists. If it's Snoop, Ray's, Dog Pound, Nate Dogg, Juelz, there's been a lot of artists on there. Instead of going to them, getting at them about an idea, I felt it was better if we went there and had something. You know, demonstration better than conversation. That's how I always looked at it. If you actually went there and said, listen to this. This is the Chronic album. This is the artwork. It's the video concept. We just did the shit and said, fuck it, we'll deal with it. Trying to make sure we get it put out later. And I think the most important thing was, it was a trust thing. The trust thing started off with me and Dre. No trust, no relationship. He trusts me enough to make sure I'm gonna handle this shit right and go to get in business with him. Then for Snoop, he trusts me enough to say, okay, I'm gonna be down with y'all and sign. And for everybody else, so that shit was like real important. Hoes know how I feel. Well, if it's good enough to get off a proper chunk, I take a small piece of some of that funky stuff. It's like this and like that and like this and it's like that and like this and like that and it's like this and like that and like this and Drake creep to the mic like a fan.
Well, I'm peeping and I'm creeping and I'm creeping. But I damn near got kept, cause my beeper kept beeping. Now it's time for me to make my impression felt. So sit back, relax, and strap on your seatbelt. You've never been on a ride like this before. With a producer who can rap and control the maestro. At the same time, with the dope rhyme that I kick, you know and I know I feel some old funky shit. To add to my collection, the selection symbolizes don't take a toke, but don't choke. If you do, you have no clue of what me and my homie Snoop Dogg came to do.
It's like this and like that and like this and it's like that and like this and like that and it's like this.
And we ain't got no love for those.
So just chill till the next episode. On that ass, what a hell of a gangster lean. Getting funky on the mic like an old batch of collard greens. It's the capital S-O-S oppression, double O-P, D-O-double-G-Y-D-O-double-G, you see. Showing much flex when it's time to wreck a mic. Pimping hoes and clacking a grip like my name was Dolomite. Yeah, and it don't quit. I think they in the mood for another one of those G hits. So Dre,
what up, dog?
We gotta give them what they want.
What's that, G?
We gotta break them off something.
Hell yeah.
And it's gotta be bumping.
City of Compton.
It's where it takes place, so a mash of attention. Mopping with the dog pound.
Bow, wow, wow.
Dropping the funky tracks is making the suckers just mumble. When I'm on the mic, it's like a cookie, they all crumble. Try to get close and you're bound to get smacked. My little homie Snoop Doggy Dog has got my back. Never let me slip, cause if I slip, then I'm slipping. But if I got my Nina, then you know I'm straight tripping. And I'ma continue to put the rap down, put the Mac down. And if your woman wanna trip, I have to put the smack down. Yeah, then you don't stop. I told you I'm just like a clock when I tick and I talk. But I'm never off, always on to the break of dawn. See you when B-T-O-N and the city they call Long Beach. Putting straight together like my homie D-O-C. No one can do it better
like this. That and this and it's like that and like this and like that and it's like this.
Then we ain't got no love for dogs.
Yeah, I hooked up with Snoop, my little brother Warren G, who was at a bachelor party.
What's up?
And he had a cassette that him and Snoop did back, you know, I think it was in a record shop called VIP. And they did a little demo tape. My brother played it for me at the bachelor party and I digged it. The next day or two, I had Snoop in the studio and we recorded.
And the game, you know, it ain't to be sold, but it's to be told. That's what they tell me. But I say, why tell it when you can sell it? You understand me? If it's gonna make you a dollar, make them holler.
I think that's me as an entrepreneur and as a black entrepreneur, as a businessman, what helped me was I wasn't caught up into the politics. I mean, I didn't go to school to say, what's the rules, how to become a record executive. So I didn't go and hang out with the guys and shoot pool with them and play golf. I was busy worrying about the artists. And the main thing I wanted Death Row to be is an artist label. Because you got a lot of labels. If you like hanging out with all the other fools rubbing elbows, they'll put in your head, fuck the artists. You know, that's their mentality. It's about us, it's not about the artists. And my thing was opposite. It's about me and my people. Fuck you.
Creeping down the back street on D.
squeeze. I got my Glock cocked to fill in the breeze, but no sooner as I said it, seems I got sweated by somebody with a Tech 9 trying to take mine. You wanna make noise, make noise. I make a phone call, my homies coming like the Gotti boys. Bodies being found on Greenleaf, laying with the heads cut off. Motherfucker, I'm straight, so listen to the play by play, day by day. Rolling in my phone with 16 switches, and got sounds for the bitches, clocking all the riches. Got the hollow points for the snitches, so won't you just walk on by, cause I'm too hard to lift. And no, this ain't Aerosmith, it's the one and only DRE from the CPT on a rhyming spree, a straight G. How back as I pop my top, you trip. I let the hollow points commence to pop, 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 yeah. Cause if it don't stop, I have to put my ride in reverse, go back and take another spot, cause I'm
rolling in my 6-4.
With all the homies saying,
you might find different executives or record company owners that might take a job somewhere else and leave their talent. That's something I would never do. There've been people offered, but I would never do that. Mm-hmm. It's like, because I feel that when an artist come to you, they put their trust, they put their dreams, they put their life in your hands. So I wouldn't have, we started Death Row, for instance, now Snoop, Dog Pound, Rage, they sign with Death Row because they know we're gonna look out for them. We're gonna be there. And I wouldn't take a job at Motown or MCA or Warner Brothers and leave it my eye. You know, my whole thing is, if I'm going somewhere, they going. If they can't go, I ain't going. And I think the most important thing about business is being real to the community, being real to the streets, because your talent's not coming out those streets. It's kind of coming from the streets. Without the talent, I don't care what company it is, what entrepreneur it is, they don't have shit. Unless they're gonna plan out there, unless they plan to rap, sing, and dance, and do every goddamn thing. One person can't do it all. Somebody gotta be about the business, and somebody gotta understand that the Hollywood is made for the artists. The videos is made for them to get their limelight and show the world that they good at what they do. If it comes to being on the record, it's their chance to get their publishing for us writing that song and performing that song. It shouldn't be nobody else up there. After each word they're saying something, they say, yeah, good, or, you know, putting their 2 cents in. Even if you have, it's a lot of shit that if I come up with an idea or a concept for a song, I'm not gonna take the credit. It's the artist. You know, that's my job, to give them a good idea if I can. That's what I'm there for. So fuck all the, you know, the credit. Just be real with your people. You'll go a lot, you know, further.
It's just another day for Dre, so I begin like this. No medallions, dreadlocks, or black fists. It's just that gangster glare with gangster raps. Them gangster tracks makes a gang of snaps. Words to my homies on the streets, and words to these hype-ass lyrics and dope beats that I hit you with, that I get you with as I groove in my 4 on D's. Hitting the switches, bitches relax while I give my proper swerve on. Bumping doggy style and about to get my serve on. But before I hit the dope spot, gotta get the chronic, the Remy Martin and my soda pop. Now I'm smelling like Indonesia, bus stop full of fly honeys and skeezers. They wanna roll in my funky 6-4, pancake front, back, side to side and all that. So when I crawl, I comes correct. Now if the hoe with my ride, it's your hoe you check, fool. Now let the Chevrolet slide as I dip and make a trip to the south side, yeah.
I'm rolling in my 6-4.
With all the hookers saying,
Sam Ryder was a good day.
I was young and we never really had been out of the neighborhood, and you know, we was getting a chance to see it all.
It's like this. We're gonna give our all for if it comes to being money, for if it comes to being time. But at the same time, I think people gotta take our judgments and know we know when to put a record out and when not to. First of all, if I sign an artist and they don't get along with the family within the circle, I let the artist go like that. I don't give a fuck who it is. If you don't get along with him, her, whatever, you got a part of this, you can't be here. We not doing this shit just to say we got all these artists and we putting all these records out. You got to enjoy what you do. It's a lot of time people make money and they're successful in their life, but they're not happy. If you ain't happy, don't mean shit. You got people who might be millionaires, who might be billionaires. These motherfuckers seeing shrinks, got ulcers, going to see psychiatrists. You know, I keep that shit real. How you call yourself a man, and you got money, but your fucking head so much fucked up from stressing out, you can't even go home and fuck your woman. You know what I'm saying? You can't even, your shit ain't even getting up. You can't even keep her happy. Better let yourself. So it ain't so much about having a gang of motherfuckers down with you. It's about having people down with you who you loving and they loving you. You can't love somebody and love you back. Come and try to attack us, only thing they doing is helping us. Because they allowing us to say, okay, they trying to cut this pass off. Let's make a better path. Let's go harder, let's get stronger. Only thing they doing is making us work harder. The harder we work, the better we get, the more we get. You know, we about to have a control of our shit. We're about just being a part of something. We want to be something, not just to be a part of it. And I think at Death Row, everybody is something. Everybody is. It's great at what they do. So, you know, we don't get caught up in the politics for us, that Hollywood shit. We're gonna put our hits, and I'm gonna make sure our people get paid, and we're gonna get paid, and we're gonna continue to grow.
No need being calm if you pack right, and learning just enough to keep your sack right. Late nights, I wonder what they getting for. Early morning on the corners, what they hitting for. Seven young G's, what they serve down. In the G-Ride, east side's what they swerve now. Not thinking about what's really going on. Got crept on, stepped on, now they gone. I spent 4 years in the county with nothing but convicts around me. But now I'm back at the pound and we exposed. Ways for the youth to survive. Some think it's wrong, but we tend to think it's right.
Death Row Uncut is gonna give them that good shit.
Look, see this over here?
Thank you.
Ass.
Ooh.
Don't worry about that.
Yeah, yeah.
They can get pussy when he can't get nothing else. They can get pussy when he can't get nothing else.
Deal with some of the money thing, it's a gamble. And you know, I ain't no big gambler. definitely gotta be love. You gotta feel somebody.
Hey, call in 10 minutes and say I did it. Just call in 10 minutes and say I did it.
Yo, Piggy, man, we got it going on, baby. It's on and cracking, man. He's gone, baby. You the man, you the man. Champagne, caviar, dreams from now on, baby. Plats, baby, straight plats, homie.
Baby, baby.
That's right. We own and cracking from now on, man. You know what I'm saying? Hey, Pop, you alive? I mean, you safe? Man, I'm so happy you're free.
Yeah? Happy to see me. Wasn't y'all talking when I got in here? Finish.
Nah. That can wait. What's important is... What's important is...
Ain't you gonna get that?
Yeah.
I did it, man.
Yeah, baby. I'll be there in 1 minute.
Who's that, Biggie?
Oh, that's just Faye. She's always checking up on me.
It's a lying piece.
Pop! Please don't kill me. It was Buff's idea.
No, man.
I'm just a rapper, man. Please don't take me out the gang.
I ain't gonna kill you. We was homeboys once, Pig. Once we homeboys, we always homeboys. Even if you is a fat phony.
Thank you, Pa.
Thank you, man. Thank you, man.
Don't thank me. Sorry.
Ain't nothing but against the party, party.
I didn't go visit Tupac and say, hey, I can get you out of jail. You know, I can make it happen for you. And then, you know, and we there for you. He came, he reached out and told somebody, tell me to come see him. I wanted to go visit him. I didn't know what he wanted. I didn't know if he wanted, you know, just to talk to somebody. I didn't know if he needed something or whatever it was. You know, this a person just like me. It's a brother who come from a neighborhood. It might not be my neighborhood, but his neighborhood no different than mine. So I wanted to go visit him. When I went to go visit him, I felt him. I feel real close to him. I trust him. Yeah, got a lot of love for him. So it was my goal and my duty to get him out. See, a lot of times what people don't understand is that if you're gonna be real about it, keep it real. You know, you don't have no choice. We put it, everybody put it in to do something. So if God blessed me to have the ability to help others, I'll be a fool not to help my people. So it ain't about the money, it ain't about, shit, we ain't around here, bro. You know, everybody's doing all right. So it's about being there for somebody, and they go a lot further.
Hey, Shug, what I tell you, nigga, when I come out of jail, what I was gonna do? I was gonna start digging into these niggas' chests, right?
Got me thinking on the main level. Shooting my gauge, you know what I mean? You gotta feel it. Because you're doing the same thing you did for Hit 'Em Up. You rapping it. This is the movies. You gotta be it. I don't even think you're serious. You're doing the Hollywood shit. You know what I mean? Y'all gotta get back to the war game. This the shit that's, you know, the movie. It's the war shit. It's not for your homeboys. It's the war shit. We about to kill niggas in the movie. And y'all niggas is rapping to the, you know?
Next person I'm introduced. I might as well see my little brother, because I get a Benz, he get a Benz. I get a Rose, he get a Rose. I get a Jag, he get a Jag. Anyway, I want everybody to give a big welcome for Tupac.
Hey, before we go into the song, I know everybody love their mama. But I want to talk about something else first. I want to talk about the people that don't have their mama no more. Because we all sometimes forget to appreciate our mothers. But like my little homeboy, Mutar, he don't got no mother today. While we all shedding smiles and being happy, they can't be happy because they don't got no mama. While Danny Boy, he's singing off for all of y'all mama. Danny Boy out here making everybody feel good. He ain't got no mama to hug him. We got to get back to that old school shit where we all care for everybody and all of us raise all these kids because we all out of hand. So last year about this time, I was sitting in a maximum security penitentiary. I couldn't sing this song for my mama, but I'm going to do it today for all y'all and all y'all mama. Dear mama, Peter. When I was young, me and my mama had beef. 17 years old, kicked out on the streets. Though back at the time, I never thought I'd see a face. Ain't a woman alive that could take my mama's place. Suspended from school and scared to go home. I was a fool with the big boys breaking all the rules. And shed tears with my baby sister Over the years, we was poorer than the other little kids. And even though we had different daddies, same drama when things went wrong, we blamed mama. I reminisce on the stress I caused. It was hell, hugging on my mama from a jail cell.
He was in a situation where he goes to prison. And you know the rumors, you know the situation, but all was there. Interscope, or anybody else, anybody of that matter. He had a manager before then, he had people before then. Not one person said, okay, I'm gonna go get Tupac out of prison.
Yo. Fresh out of jail, I don't care. We gonna show you how we do it on death row, run that shit. I got the dog pound in this motherfucker, rapping 4K. And I got my niggas up in this biatch. I know it's been a long time. Niggas done heard a lot of shit. A lot of shit done went down. Turn that shit up. We got mad enemies. No friends. Turn it up. No love. Police wanna see a nigga in chains. Niggas trying to lock me up in this game. I've been framed, shot down, and banned. These niggas can't understand me.
Time Tupac got his girl to call me and said he need me. I wasn't late. I'm on the next thing smoking to go down there to get him out of prison.
Turn that shit up!
So many tears, y'all.
Shed so many tears.
Come on, let's get live in this motherfucker
up.
Tonight.
Throw your hands up. Throw your hands up.
Shed so many tears.
God forgive me for my motherfucking sins. I never meant to call somebody no problems. I shed so many tears. I sat up in that motherfucking maximum state penitentiary, baby.
Pac is another half of me, which is a little brother. So anything I could do to help him, it was great for both of us. Not because of his talent as an artist. You got a lot of people that like Pac because of he can rap. I like Pac because of Pac, because of who he was. And if you look at it, is everybody now, since he's not around, everybody claims that they was great friends. Everybody do a show. Some artists knew him, but like Pac and Snoop at the end hated each other. And you could tell that by the simple fact that when Snoop did Dogfather, Pac was not on that one song. And Pac didn't like Dre.
If you were that artist, I love you, but if you were homo, Dre not gonna be here today.
Not today.
No longer Dre Day or even Dirt Jake.
Dre not gonna be
here. He said he
If you're looking for Dre, he's not gonna be here. You got peanuts.
That would change the death row camp because of the jealousy of Tupac. Because Tupac was now all of a sudden now, he's this major star. He getting all the light. He getting all the attention. So, you know, that to me, you know, was childish on their part, but they can never feel the shoes that Pac feel by walking the life that he walked.
To live in down LA, where everybody try to fatten their pocket. So many hustle for the cash, so it's hard to knock it. Everybody got their own thing, currency chasing. Worldwide through the hard times, worrying faces. Shed tears as we bury brothers close to heart. What was a friend, now a ghost in the dark. Hard part about it, brother got smoked by a fiend. Trying to floss on him, blind to a broken man's dream. A hard lesson, court cases keep them guessing. Plea bargain ain't an option now, so I'm stressing. Cost me more to be free than a life in the bin. Making money over cuss words, writing again. Learn how to think ahead, so I fight with my pen. Late night, down sunset, like in the sin. What's the worst they could do to a player? Got me lost in hell to live and die in L.A. on bail. My people say,
living die in L.A., the place to be.
To live and die in L.A.
God decided to pull his belt out, and it was time for Death Row Records to take a whipping.
You know, when I first got arrested, I had to go to court. And I had a feeling that I would be staying on the simple fact that it was on the news that said that I fled the country without my PO's permission. And so I came in, I know I didn't flee the country because I had permission and I was in the Bahamas and I was in the studio.
when I came to court, I had my suit on, but I also had my tennis shoes there. Because I figured, you know, if I had to stay in the county jail, I don't want to be walking around with no gaiters, put some tennis shoes on. The feeling wasn't really, it wasn't a negative feeling. It was just, okay, what is it about? And I get to the county jail, and they tell me that I didn't flee the country. Then they said I must have had a dirty test. I didn't have a dirty test. And they said, well, we still gonna hold you for a while. So I didn't have no bail. I wasn't allowed no bail. I wasn't allowed anything. So when I got ready to go to trial for a violation hearing, I felt at the time where I couldn't, they wouldn't allow me to wear my own clothes and becoming handcuffed and shackled. You know, it's obvious at that point that it don't take a rocket science to figure out that, you know, you're gonna be doing some time for something because they're not, you know, they usually can't, if it's OJ or murderers or whatever, to wear their own clothes. So when they denied me to wear my own clothes, I knew it was like a rocky road. So I was pretty much prepared and prepped to deal with whatever the consequences I had to deal with.
And there were times I didn't think I'd make it through. I went through so many phases that got me so many cases. Three strikes, you're gone. Then what you're gonna do?
I must be weighing about 375. I'm 330 now, right? But I didn't know my stomach got that big. So I got a little bump. My stomach fell over here. I'm like, ah. They tell me I'm in shape. I look good. They was just lying to me.
Somebody was naughty when they snitched on me, and the judge just sentenced me to do about a century. No more endo, gin and juice. I'm on my way to Chino, rolling on the Grey Goose, shackled from head to toe. 25 with a Izzel with nowhere to gizzo. I know them.
When I first came to prison, I went from, I've been in three prisons. I was in Chino, I was in Delano, I was in CMC, and Mill Creek. I'm not saying this because I'm at Mill Creek right now, but I think Mill Creek, even though it was towards the end, it was, Mill Creek is more of a professional staff for the program. It's like CMC was like real petty. You know, everything was real, real, real petty. But most of all is, you got to be honest with yourself. With me, I felt like, well, whatever this test I got to go through, whatever it is, God made me a man. So whatever the consequence it is, well, if somebody say, we're gonna handcuff you to a tree, if that what it takes to do my time, that's what it takes. I know when I was at Delano, I was in the hole. They put a plexiglass in front of the cell. That the people who lie and are spitters or throwing, you know, feces at the guards as they come by. They put one of those in front of my cell, and at one point, to be able to breathe, after, you know, you're definitely gonna work out. If you're in the cell, you're definitely gonna do your calisthenics, you're gonna do your push-ups. That will motivate you, that will keep your body going, that will keep your mind going. So after working out, I have to take a bird bath, it used to be like hard to breathe. And it was at one point that I would take writing paper, roll it up, sleep on the floor, stick the paper up under the crack of the cell and breathe through it. And the thing that got me the most is that it didn't affect me mentally or physically. You know, there was a time where I went and said, I want to talk to a lawyer. I want a better arrangement. You know, I don't deserve this. You know, I look at it as you got to be responsible for your actions. Not saying what I did was wrong or what saying I did was right or anything. But you can't constantly make excuses, because every time somebody make excuses, they want to blame everybody else. They want to blame this person, want to blame that person. At a point, you got to blame yourself. Not for as much to blame, but you got to stand up under it. And with me, I was like, okay, they gave me 9 years. After 9 years, I ended up doing 5. You can't have faith in God on Friday and be stressing on Saturday. You got the same God. But I think most of all is how you grew up. You know, I was fortunate and blessed to have my father, which my father's still around. And one thing about it, I had like 10 uncles and my father. So you got to be a man. Start off as a young man, then you can become a man. And, you know, force that whining and making excuses and complaining, that ain't going to do no good. And telling is definitely something you don't do. You outside playing with your, you know, with your friends, and they might be older, and you run and say, hey, I'm 7 years old, and they 14, and they took my ball. And the first thing my pops would say, look, boy, don't be no telltale. Get your butt back out there and get your ball back. And I think that that guidance, is that father figure, is very, very important. Because if you look at a lot of people who do a lot of telling and a lot of crying and be snitches and stuff, they didn't have that father presence around. When I was young, I got whoopings. I think, but I deserved those whoopings. I didn't get whoopings, I got ass whoopings. You know, I was a boy, I was all boy. You know, I wasn't feminine, so I was all boy. So by me being all boy, I broke windows, I did stuff to cars, and you know, and my people weren't rich. So when I broke a window, and that means an extra $100 for that month that depended on that money for some, I got an ass whooping. I think my whoopings was so tough. If, like today, kids can call the child services on them, right? If I'd have called the child services on my people, they'd still be in jail doing time. But I deserve every one of the whoopings. But back to the Forest Prison, it's like one of the saddest things. I wouldn't say it's real sad, but it's true. It's like Forest, no matter what prison I go to, I'm going to have a gang of homeboys there. If I go to college, I might know one person from my neighborhood. But and the thing about it is, the worse the prison is, the better it is for me. On the simple fact that lifers and guys got a gang of time, those are the majority of my homeboys. And you know, the system is what it is. You know, you get guys in the system that for murder do 3 or 4 years. Child molesters is the worst. These guys who affect kids for the rest of their life, these guys do 2 or 3 years. I guess a guy named Cobbs or whatever who killed Sharon Tate and the baby, they treat this guy like a king, you know. And this guy did a serious crime. Cause I'm giving dirt naps.
Keep that damn car out of the water. I mean, call the Coast Guard or something. You never sleep,
cause every time you... One thing about being from the ghetto, you're going to have a debt to pay sooner or later. If you live in a fast life, you come into prison, you know, regardless if you did something serious, if you did something minor. There's no way you can be off the block and hang out and don't come to penitentiary. Unless, you know, the guys on the streets, that unless they're informants or snitches, you know, they're more important to the authorities on the street than in prison. But if you're a guy that really hangs out really from the neighborhood, sooner or later you're going to get crossed up.
Got me up against the fence, back against the wall. Get to acting like a fool, say no justice for the dog. Got to take it out on all y'all. Better read the papers on my homies going crazy. Baby, only got the papers. Got my mind to come and see. Hurry, see, I ain't bummed. It's a gangster party. So bad boy getting bummed. Snoop Dogg, why they fantasize? When we ride, it's a must. Have a seven die.
every time.
Yes, yes, y'all. Not show much Snoop Dogg. And you know it's like that, y'all.
I'm so smooth about my paper check, it this eye's done. I'm serving mini on a platter, Snoop Dogg, Coleon, Coleon. Now do you know what that mean? The Teflon Don to this hip-hop game, super supreme. It's like what happened can happen, but will it stop? That won't happen. I'm feeling good about the mission for Jack and the Yo-Pop. Can you feel me? Why these fools trying to kill me? It's so hard to stay focused on my eyes and pride, but if I don't, then dog won't survive.
We ballin', in my opinion, eternal was why wheel spinning. Once implemented, it's represented for 5 minutes. Two of the livest, one of the dead or alive. We ride us, been us because we acquired and watched the G's ride. Two of America's most straight out the west. So bell down, fool, this is death row. Been waiting way too long, rest out the pin, now it's on. Come on, Snoop Dogg, time to bone.
Every time we do a two-part record, it's definitely going to do it. But more importantly, it's from the fans. More importantly, I'll be home to really do it the way I've been seeing.
Take a look through the eyes of a G and just rock to the rhythm of a gangsta.
Homeboy's telling me, ain't no love for a real G. Straight cowards, all you player haters kill me. Throw up your hands if you feel me. We getting dollars, homie, holla if you hear me.
The only record that I would put out of the Tupac record, because Tupac did a diss song. Talking about Snoop, how he ain't no gangbanger, how he got funk, how he one time he was being a diamond, then he said better he got a power room, and said he's 19th Street, 20th Street, insane. Then he said he was just, you know, different little things, and he said the only time he ever went to jail, it wasn't no prisons, when he sold crack to his own mother, and she told on him. So he did a real serious diss record. Then he talked about how he was at the New York and the MTV Awards, and how, you know, Snoop on a radio station, Hot 97, saying that he down with the East Coast, he down with Puffy, he don't care about what Pac talking about. And then Pac also put in first where when he socked Snoop, Snoop ran and got in the van when he rode with the Nuggets. And those type of things, I felt, you know, Pac, was, even though it was true, he was just speaking out because he was pissed. So I said, you know, I don't have to throw that record out there, even though he's done it. But everything else, it's a lot of stuff that will be done. I know when Drake came and had a conversation with me, he said, look, I want something more than anything in, you know, possibly more than anything in the world. And I said, what's that? And he said he wanted to be white. I said, well, look, I ain't God. I can't make you white. You know, I'm a manager and all things. I mean, you can make enough money and you can act white and you can live white, but I can't make you white. And he said, well, Jimmy told me that he can put me on a level where I don't have to cuss on my records and I can live that type of way. He said to Jimmy, you know, and I was shocked. I was like, well, you know, where all this come from? Being, you know, being black and all of a sudden you want to be white, you know. I tell him the only way to be, you know, white, you probably can never be, but if you can marry a white person and you can have, then your kids more likely to be more white instead of just black. And, you know, I feel we friends because he take my advice because he done it. You know, he married a white lady, he got, you know, missed kids, which is good. Anything is good for those guys to live their life and move forward.
Dre told me he would sell his soul to the devil for $1 million. And I swear right now, devil got to have a receipt for his ass.
Is that a saying?
He doesn't live here.
I haven't seen it in the video.
Let me handle this. Nah, he rented this from us. This Death Row compound.
No diggity.
No doubt.
Today, uncovering information that Alizé, formerly of Death Row Records, has received undeserved
of several hit songs. Further investigation is underway to find out the real man behind the music.
Oh my God.
Yo, Barney, these fools talking about how they pay. I ain't telling you got that way by jerking brothers, you know what I'm saying?
Who been there? Done that? You got snaps, cause you still raps. A million MCs on the planet Earth. Watch your back and be game or you will get jerked. Who been there? Who done that? You got snaps, cause you still raps. A million MCs on the planet Earth. Watch your back and be game or you will get jerked.
No question, the real about the DRE is that he damn near had me writing rhymes for free. Ain't trying to give a brother no royalty. Make a mill off my hits and give me a few G's since way back when he was with EZ. Stealing credit from Snoop in the DOC. Can't forget Barney Rubble in the DAZ. Ain't did it on his own since 73. Worldwide, can't deny the fact you lie. Got brother steady working while you steady jerking. On the side, snatching styles. And you know what's really foul is people wonder how you do it with a smile. It's the real, not out of spite. If it wasn't for Suge Knight, you'd still be working for Tamika Wright. Do your math before the aftermath. Or feel the wrath. I'm kicking the real for brothers who don't know the half.
Who been there? Who done that? You got snaps, cause you still raps. A million MCs on the planet Earth. Watch your back and peep game or you will get jumped. Who been there? Who done that? You got snaps, cause you still raps. A million MCs on the planet Earth. Watch your back and peep game or you will get jumped.
Young black Ebenezer, Scrooge, betrayed us like Caesar. Pocket squeezer, gas my head like some good reefer. Cause a fool and his dough soon split. So I guess I played the fool and he got what he could get. But I'm a little wiser now, so I guess he gotta find another pen pal. The jacket style and live off they flows. He wanted me to fire my manager, cause she was asking about my pesos. Doing things like that, you never be the Quincy Jones of rap. It only gets you wiped off the map. You out the screw. You got my loot, I'm finna sue. But if you was true, you wouldn't do what you do. But instead, you take other brothers' rhymes and beats and say that you did them. Just because you twisted and tweaked. J Flex with the real coming from inside your crew, letting the whole damn world know who.
Who been there? Who done that? You got snaps, cause you still raps. A million MCs on
Hello.
The planet Earth.
I'm
watch
Ira.
Your back and peace game or you will get jumped.
You take somebody who didn't have anything to do with Death Row, but they want to try to do a documentary on Death Row for one thing, to make money. You get a guy on there, they say who's doing the thing, this is a guy named Mike.
People refer to him as Harry O. Convicted notorious drug dealer named Michael Harris.
David Kinner was his lawyer. He said this guy is a known rat, known informant. Him and his wife, Lydia, trying to tell on people just to get this guy out of prison. Yeah, I think that's sad that you gotta do whatever you gotta do.
Harry O is a punk and a snitch, a punk and a snitch.
And then you get a guy that I heard speak on me saying, well, how much did he say he was? Death Row took from him?
Millions, man.
Okay, well, there's two things. If a guy take millions of dollars from you, right? And if it's true, even though it wasn't, but if it's true, if a guy take millions of dollars from you, either you're a punk or you're a snitch for telling on him, saying something about it. Either you snitching about something that you shouldn't be telling about if it's true, and if it's not true, and they took the money, you're a punk. So you had your choices. What you want to be, a rat, or you want to be a punk? Or do you just want to just sit back as a man and deal with it? You know, if that was me and somebody did that situation to me, I would deal with it as a man. I wouldn't let nobody punk me, or I wouldn't be a snitch.
He had asked me if you snitched on somebody that wasn't your same ethnic color, would that be considered snitching? You know, and I told him, yeah, snitching is snitching. You know what I'm saying? And then come to find out, you know, how he was, you know, trying to fabricate some stories against Suge, you know, and I'm putting them two together and I'm like, oh, this dude is do bad business, man.
State, federal, and local agencies started to investigate the label's links to organized crime and Harris's allegations of financing Death Row Records with drug money. Drug money. Drug money.
In my opinion, this is a miscarriage of justice.
My name is Richard Subia. I am the assistant to the warden at Mule Creek State Prison. There's always people that are going to try to get over. There's always people that have what we call the hustle, somebody who's got their hustle. And somebody who's going to try to manipulate you, whether it's your own children, whether it's your next door neighbor.
As the two men fight it out while behind bars, Death Row Records, the label that crime may have built, continues to fire out the hits and rake in the dough.
Watching the whole world move in slow-mo. Five times disappear, listen to the ocean. Smoking ports, think my thoughts, then it's back to posting. Who can I trust in this cold world? My phony homie.
My name is Aaron Cardoza. They call me AB. I'm from Sacramento, California, Del Paso Heights. And prison, I've been there on 8 years now. I came to jail for carjacking in Sacramento and assault with a deadly weapon inside Arden Fair Mall. First, I was scared because you get all the rumors, man. Don't drop the soap. Don't do this.
You was out, man. What kind of music did you listen to?
Rap music.
Yeah.
R&B.
What was your
favorite?
Pop. Yeah.
Tupac. Yeah. So.
When you activate your hips and push your ass out. Got a brother wanting it so bad I'm about to pass out. Wanna dig you. And I can't even lie about it, baby. Just alleviate your clothes. I'm the fly about. Catch you at the club. Your hips have got me feeling. Body talking quick to me, but I can't comprehend the meaning. Now if you wanna roll with me, then here's your chance. Luminating on the freeway. Catch me if you can.
So I feel Pac kind of like, you know what I'm saying, was inspiration to me based on the fact that his lifestyle and my lifestyle was kind of coincide together, you know. Yeah, I was born and raised in group homes and foster homes, and everything was, I'm trying to be the man as far as, cause like the other cats out there having nice cars, and but I never had it, you know what I'm saying? I never had it, so I'm trying to, you know, once he bubbled up, he was able to get out there and shine now, you know what I'm saying? Look what I can do, you know, as far as, you know what I'm saying, having his nice cars and stuff like that, and, you know, his mom. And my mom, you know, like my mom, she in the pen right now, you know what I'm saying, child chiller. It's just the same little thing with me and him, you know what I'm saying? He rapped what he felt in his expression, and that's why it's so tight, because he rapped it real.
Thank you.
strawberry shake and shit, some real fries. I'm about ready. Baby!
Biggest shit, I'm gonna reach.
Pull up, love, you know Chica Man resume. Blow up drugs, blast round, 4 pound, no mask or glove. Face down on the gravel, have fun, will travel. I don't lose, still barrel, get your crew killed. Parrow ass niggas can't touch ya. Motherfucker, what's my name? Young Ho, gun blow like AC, ROC with the
DPG. Hold up, wait a minute. All my thugs get gangsta with it.
Got a jigger and Daz Dillinger killing you with the pound. We rock lock for millions.
Yeah, niggas ain't feeling that.
Dynasty in the Pentagon, motherfucker. Hollow tip, stainless Teflon, motherfucker. Jigga trigger, cocker pop a nigga, chest rocker with the chrome chopper, cocker pop a nigga so quick. Dom the Oscar, y'all stepped in the mud and about to steal everything from the flat foot. Calico's collective, have you ever seen him? Four so clean like a brand new Nina, my nigga Dash.
Single, single.
Jigga Memphis, badass, Impala, butt naked bitches and pop collars, the popular scholar. This is the beginning with the hollow tip scoring. Chrome wheel spinning. Never have you ever seen a G like me. Like rolling with the rock straight DPG.
Don't change the game for these hoes. Play the game like we supposed.
My nigga Dad's in the house.
DPGC4LIFB. Rock me your double G.
Don't change the game for these.
We're gonna be over studio time. You gonna be over studio time?
Yeah.
Okay, let's get it.
Butch. Right. Should have Butch here.
Yeah.
Bow wow wow, yippee yo, yippee yay, doggy dogs definitely in the house. Bow wow wow, yippee yo, yippee yay, death rose definitely in the house.
We got our own little world, we doing our own shit. Either motherfuckers riding with us, or they riding against us. Ain't no in between, either you with us or against us. Those who with us, we got love for you. Those who not with us, you don't even exist. You know, ain't like a motherfucker say, bam, I hate him, I don't like him, I don't even know you. You're nothing. So that's the way how we do it, and anybody got a problem with it, you know how we do it.
Tell me this. Hypothetical, can I? You're free, yes. You're free, you walk in the streets, you walk into a party, standing in there, it's Puffy, Dre, Snoop. What do you say?
First of all, you know I don't go to those type of parties. You know, I'm straight. All me. Cool on me. Now, if you want to say I go there and it's a regular club with all the women and they happen to be there, it's possible we might run across each other.
What are you doing? Say you run into them at a record.
A regular party.
Regular
with women
party.
Stuff. Right.
You haven't lost your sense of humor.
Hey, it's the facts. Can't you hurt something?
What will you say if say you run into Snoop? What will you say to him?
Actually, if I seen him, I'd probably be saying hi to the back of his ego. I know he'd probably be running. Not for me, the guy that's paranoid, it's schizophrenical or something. Nice and thick around here. Used to be drink orange juice and sodas and shit. Y'all been working out, huh? Water and shit. Everybody been working out? Can't even like you been working out. Working out? Don't suck it up now. You can't be. You pass out. Just let it all out, huh? Yeah. Alright, basically, what this be. You know, it's been a little going on 5 years. That'd be 6 years in layoffs. Now we ready for boot camp. Double days, hell week, like football time.
We're gonna pick out which artists we're gonna put out, what acts we're gonna put out. It's gonna be about time for everybody to just dial in on their position. I know lately there's probably been a lot of things going on. This person doing this person's job, this person doing his job, and trying to help everybody. Now we gotta make it real simple. That's the way we're gonna get this out.
The only one who comes closer to having maybe 10, 15, 20 seconds before their live is the president. Notorious for it, man. He was.
Well, you know, off the record, me and Clinton had a lot of things to count. We both had cigars, and we both was king on head.
Thank you, man. Appreciate it.
Take care, buddy.
Take care.